And this all have left it away from your life. Now your heart is empty. But still you are thinking that, no, I am free. No, you are enjoying and you are drinking, you are going in parties and you are doing the such kind of worldly things. And that spirit will drop in here and there. And he goes, ah, my old home still is same. And then he will collect his friends. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bring and make a bigger storm and more weaker than before. He will make a home in your heart. So my brothers and sisters, it's very important to change our heart, to change our mind. If we don't change, my brothers and sisters, tomorrow we will not receive what God He has put in for us. So today is in your hand. Tomorrow is in God's hand. Because of today, don't lose tomorrow what you are going to receive. Hallelujah. Amen. So what we must do? Baptism is the last step to go to enter in the kingdom of God. Before baptism, there is a repent. There is a confess. You must confess from your tongue, from your lips, from your mouth. Repent. If you don't repent, and I know it's very difficult, very few. So that's the Bible says the gate is narrow and very few people will enter on that day. Very few from 100 people, maybe 2 or 3 will enter from that gate, because that gate is go to the eternal life. Hallelujah. Amen. There is a peace in that gate. There is a wonderful blessings in that gate. To enter, if you want to enter in that gate, you receive the kingdom of God in your life and your name is written in the book of heaven, then nobody can change. Even the demons, they will come and they will run away from you, because there will some light is shining in your flesh. If some light is shining in your soul, in your face, they will never come around you, never can touch you. Because there is that come, because the John Baptist said, I am baptizing the people with the water, but who is coming after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. Hallelujah. If that fire is burning in you, no demons, no satanic power, no government, nobody can touch you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is a great power in the Holy Spirit, in the fire, my brothers and sisters. To receive that fire, we must turn our way. Turn to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, my friends, they are still in problem and they are looking at me in the Facebook, my videos and my what we are doing here. They said, who come? I said, this is not in my hand. This is not in your hand. This is not my wife's hand. But then this is everything in God's hand. If you need your future bright, think today, my brothers and sisters. Think today. Today is yours. The future is in God's hand. You never know tomorrow what can happen. But today, if you receive the salvation of God, the God will give you the bright future in your life. And the people of your friends and your parents will show you, will see you, you will be the light. And the Bible says, if one of the family members receives the salvation of God, the whole family member will receive the salvation of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The Bible says, if one righteous man in the city, I will say, the city. That promise was with Abraham. The Abraham said to God, Lord God, I am a righteous. You know, if I am here, and if you put some bomb here, if you put something happen to here, why? Why I must die? He said, no, because of you, I will say, the city. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So because of you, because of one soul, if you receive the salvation of God, your parents, wherever they are, in Nigeria, in Libya, you pray for them and they will receive the salvation in their life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because why? We have some connection in spirit with our parents, with our friends. When you start to pray, yesterday I was praying all night. I was praying for Libya, praying. I know that Holy Spirit was touching them. Hallelujah. Because if you pray for someone, my brothers and sisters, that pray never broke in the way, because you already received the salvation of God in your life. The satanic power, the satanic wall, the satanic chains, it has broken from your life when you receive, when you repent, when you receive the salvation of God in your life. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of God.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of God.
Amen.
So I will stop here, otherwise I will never stop here. So better we will stop here. So the topic was for